and let's start with synthesis of mechanism. First, let us see what is a mechanism. What is a mechanism? For example, if we consider a 4-bar mechanism, this will be the L1, that will be the fixed link, L2, this will be the crank to which the input will be given, L3 will be the coupler link, and L4 will be the output link. So, synthesis is the process of designing of a mechanism to get the required output for the given input. If we want oscillation motion of the link L4, we need to give oscillation input to link L2, and so for that purpose, synthesis of a mechanism needs to be done. The types or the steps in the synthesis of a mechanism are mainly divided in 3 parts, that is, type synthesis, number synthesis, and the third one is dimension synthesis. So, let's get started with the first one, that is the type synthesis. In type synthesis, we mainly determine what link or material are we going to use in our mechanism. The link may be binary, ternary, quaternary, material may be cast iron, steel, aluminium, etc. as per the requirement. In the number synthesis, we find out the number of links which will be required in a mechanism. For example, in a 4-bar mechanism, we require 4 links. The number of joints in the mechanism, so this will be first, the second, third, and the fourth joint which will be required to complete our mechanism. Another factor which can be used in number synthesis is degree of freedom. Degree of freedom gives us the relative motion of a mechanism in various planes for one single given input. So, the degree of freedom can be found out by using the Grubbler's criteria, and this is number synthesis. Dimension synthesis is the last and the final step of synthesis of a mechanism, which includes finding out the dimension and exact position and angles of a mechanism so as to design it and fit the designed mechanism in the confined space provided to us as per the final design and the prototype. So, this is all about the steps in the synthesis. So, when the synthesis is done, we need to see if the mechanism fits that the precision points as per the design. Now, what are precision points? These are the spacing or the distance between which the mechanism will function exactly as it is designed for. Precision points shows us where the mechanism might fail or vary from the desired output which we wanted from the mechanism during the design stage. So, the determination of precision points Now, consider a function y is equal to f of x. Let's plot x1, x2, x3 and x4 on the x-axis and y1, y2, y3 and y4 on the y-axis. Let's connect them. Okay, so we will get a straight line if we join the midpoints of these coordinates. The function is y is equal to f of x. If these are the points at which our mechanism will meet. If the graph was supposed to be like this, we may get a graph like this. So at these points, this will be the p1, p2, p3 and p4, we will get precision points at which the mechanism will meet the required input or the required output which we were designed for. The next question is how to find these precision points so as to solve the numerical. It is found out using a theorem named Chebyshev spacing. Now, what is a Chebyshev spacing? It is basically a theorem used to find out the spacing between these precision points at which the mechanism will meet. It has a straight simple formula. Let's not get into the detail of the formula as it is not included in the syllabus and it has no derivation. So, it is used for best spacing of precision points and it is given by, let xj be the precision point, 1 upon 2 bracket xf plus xs minus 1 upon 2 xf minus xs cos pi 2j minus 1 upon 2n. Okay, so this will be the formula for Chebyshev spacing. Xf will show the finish point. Xs will show the start point. N will be number of precession points. And J will be the precision point number. So this is the formula for Chebyshev spacing. We should consider taking the sequence as mentioned xf plus xs because we may get jumbled in this term when we take xs and xf alternately. So consider xf plus xs to be in the same position as mentioned. Next, this is the Chebyshev spacing. Consider to keep your calci in the radian mode because the cos term in the inside term of the cos does not have any trigonometric function. So it needs to be in the radian so as to get the correct answer for the following numerical. Consider keeping your calculator in the radian mode for Chebyshev spacing. So let's take a numerical and see what the Chebyshev spacing is and how it works. Let's consider a function y is equal to log 10 to the base x. We have been given the start point as 1 and finish point as 5 and we have to equally space it in 3 precision points. So as per the formula mentioned, it will be 1 upon 2 5 plus 1 minus 1 upon 2 5 minus 1 cos pi 2 into j will be first point, so 1 upon 2 into number of precision points 3. This will be the formula for x1. So let's calculate for the given term. Mind it, my calci is in the radian mode, it's in the R as you can see. Let's start with the calculation. 1 divided by 2 bracket 5 plus 1 finish plus start minus 1 divided by 2 5 minus 1 finish minus start cos shift pi 2 into 1 first point minus 1 upon 2 into 3 bracket close is equal to 3 minus under root 3. Press the SD button, 1.2679. Similarly, for second point, 1 upon 2, 5 plus 1, minus 1 upon 2, 5 minus 1, cos pi, 2 into 2 because we are considering second point upon 2 into 3. Similarly, solving it, we will be getting the answer approximately 3. And similarly solving for x3 we will be getting as 4.732. Now we have x1, x2 and x3. So we can calculate y1 by putting it in the function log 10 to the base 1.2679 which will be approximately 0.1030, or y2 which will be log 10 to the base 3 which is equal to 0.4771, and y3 will be log 10 to the base 4.732 which will be approximately 0.675. So friends, this is Chebyshev Spacing, and I'll come back to you with another video and sharing another stuff. Thank you. Mechanism turns. Let's consider a 4-bar mechanism and let the starting angle of the input link be theta s and that of the output link be phi s. For example, if this mechanism turns through some angle and also the coupler link may turn, which will in change the angle of the output link, which will be phi s1, and this will be theta s1. So when it changes at certain points, the angle will change and so will the output and input link. We can find out the angle of the mechanism, how it turns, by using certain formulas. Those formulas are theta s is equal to, this might be the number of angles through which the mechanism turns, which will be del theta upon del x bracket xf minus xs plus theta s. So the term here included are theta s1 will be the position angle, del theta will be the difference between the start and the finish angle, which will be provided in the question, del x will be the difference between start and finish position, and theta s will be the starting angle of mechanism. Similarly, this was for the input link. For the output link, we can use del phi upon del y, del phi upon del y, yf minus ys plus phi s. The same terms are used. Phi, del phi will be the difference of the output link. Del y will be the y1, y2, finish and start positions of y. Yf will be the finish position, Ys will be the start position, and phi s will be the initial angle of the output link of the mechanism. So friends, let's solve a numerical on Chebyshev spacing as well as finding the angles of a mechanism, which will constitute one whole numerical in your exam paper. Let's take a solved example from previous question papers, which will have a function as y is equal to 1 by x, and the limits were given as y equal, so less than or equal to x, which is less than or equal to 3. We were given theta s and phi s as 30 and 200 degree respectively. So theta s was 30 degree, phi s was 200 degree respectively. We have to space it in 3 equal precision points. So we were given this given data. Let's start considering the limits which were given. It corresponds to xs is equal to 1 and xf is equal to 3. So this was the limits which will be used to find the start and the finish position. Now as soon as we get these, we can find del x will be 3 minus 1, which is equal to 2. So we have the del x. Now let's put it in the y. So ys will be 1 upon xs, which is 1 upon 1, which will be 1. Yf will be 1 upon xf, which will be 1 upon 3, which is going to be 0.6667. This might be 0.3337. So we have the answers of yf and ys. So del y will be yf minus ys, which will be, we are also provided with del theta is equal to del phi is equal to 90 degree. So del theta is equal to del phi is equal to 90 degree, which can be used to find theta 1, theta 2 and theta 3 respectively. So let's start with the Chebyshev spacing formula for the first point, 1 upon 2. Remember the finish position, then the start position, minus 1 upon 2, xf minus xs cos pi 2j minus 1 upon 2n in the radian mode. Okay, so 1 upon 2. What was the finish position? 3 first minus 1 upon 2, 3 minus 1 cos of pi 2 into 1 minus 1 upon 2 into 3 precision points. So we'll get x1 is equal to 1.1339. similarly x2 and x3 will be 2 and 2.866. if we put the values of x1, x2 and x3 in y, we will get y is equal to 1 upon 1.1339, which is equal to 0.88. y2 is equal to 0.5 and y3 is equal to 0.349. So in this way, half of our numerical is almost over. Let's go towards finding the angles theta 1, and as per the formula, it was theta s, the start angle, plus del theta upon del x bracket. Now we have to consider the positions x1 minus the start position always. We have been given theta s as 30 degree, del theta as 90 degree. We have found out del x will be 2, x1 as 1.1339 and x is as the start position 1, which will give us theta 1 is equal to 36.02 degree. Next, similarly theta 2 will be theta s 30 plus 90 divided by 2. In space of x1 you have to put a 2 minus 1, which will give you it as 75, and theta 3 will be same 30 plus 90 divided by 2, 1.1339 minus 1, which will give you theta 3 as 113.97. So this was the theta that will be the input angles of a mechanism. Let's find the phi 1, which will be phi s plus del phi upon del y, y1 minus ys. We have the ys, we have ys, we have del phi, we have phi s and we have del y. We also have y1. So substituting the above values in the equation, we will get phi 1 as 184.05 degree, phi 2, which will be phi s, that is 200 degree, plus del phi, we are given as 90 degree, del y we can find out, y1 which is 0.8 and ys which is equal to 1. So putting all the equations, we have to use y2 for a second angle, this is 0.5, we have to substitute and we get 132.50 degree. Phi 3 is equal to 112.10. So this is it for the Chebyshev spacing and the angles, and this numerical might consist of 6 or 8 marks in your examination along with a 4 mark theory question. So friends, we can also find out the number of precision points and their spacing graphically, and today we are going to discuss about graphical method of finding out the precision points. So let's take down a question which was in the previous question paper. We have been given a function y is equal to e raised to x. Also we have been given xs is equal to 0, xf is equal to 4, and it has to be placed in 3 precision points. It has to be spaced between 3 precision points. So the first step, as usual, finding del x, which will be xf minus xs, 4 minus 0, which is going to be 4. So the first step in graphical method is to draw a circle of del x diameter. But as the diameter might be only 4 cm or 4 units, we can double the scale, that is 1:2 for the given numerical, or you can continue with del x is equal to 4 units diameter. So you will be needing a compass around a cup and a ruler. So first let's measure the diameter 8 cm from the point. So this is 8 cm and we draw a circle. So friends, the circle is completed and we have to now make a central line serration in the circle. I am using a pen for this purpose. You can also use a pencil, as I don't have a pencil. So this will be the middle point. Take your divider or the protractor, keep it on the exact center points. And we have to divide the circle in the number of precision points which have been mentioned. So that will be 3 parts which will form a hexagon in the circle. The first point will be 45, second will be 90, and the third point will be at 135 degree. So I have marked all the points, and so now I have joined the lines to and fro for all the points in which it was divided, and now the circle is complete. The points were divided as 45, 90 and 135. I drew a line across a perpendicular and then I connected the dots. Make sure and be careful you make a hexagon of exactly the same shape. If you tilt the hexagon and make it the other way around, you won't get the correct values because it will start from this point and end at this point. We need points to be from this end to this end, right from the edges of the 3 points we had divided it earlier. So now your diagram is completed and this will be the start position, this will be the finish position, and this point, the perpendicular line which will meet to the x-axis from above position, will indicate x1. The middle portion will be the middle point will be x2, and the last point will be x3. You have to measure the points right from x's. Suppose this point here from x's to x1 will be 3 cm linearly, so we have to divide it by 2. So as to get the correct answer in the proportionate scale above, we have doubled the scale, so we have to take 50% of the original answer. It will be 1.5, and suppose if we get this point and this point as 10, you have to divide it by 2, so as to get 5 cm, that will be the correct answer. When you get the above answers for x1, x2 and x3, when you get the x1 position or the x1 answer which I was getting on a graph paper was 0.25, x2 will be 2 and x3 will be 3.75. so these are the answers I was getting on a graph paper, and you can find out the y value by e raised to x1 e raised to x2 e raised to x3, which will be around 1.284, 7.389 and 42.5271. These are the approx answers of what you get for the corresponding values, and you have found out successfully the precision points using graphical method. You can verify these answers using Chebyshev spacing. And thank you for watching. If you liked it, like it subscribe and comment in the section below so as to improve the video.